I'm going to create a simple order processing system. So we should be able to place an order by calling this Azure function, and we should be able to pass order and location information to the function as a query string or else from the request body. So this is HTTP trigger request. So request from request body also we should be able to pass the data. So when the order and location both is passed to the function, order item will be inserted to a queue storage. So that's the requirement, that's the function we are going to implement. Okay, let's see how to do that. Before doing any changes to this function app, let's try to run this application. Let's go to debug and click on start debugging. So in the terminal window you can see this function app is running. So you can call this HTTP trigger using this URL. Okay, so now let's stop this one and let's try to modify this function app to accommodate our request. Okay, so first of all we have to pass order and location information. Okay, so I have changed the function app as per the requirement. So it's going to check the request in the query string. It's going to check whether we have passed order or location information. So if that's not available in the query string, it's going to read the request body. So from the request body, it's going to identify order item and the location information. If order item and the location information is available, we are going to add that order item into this queue. So the queue is passed as a parameter to the function we have developed. So it's going to insert this order and the location information to the queue in this format, and it's going to print this new order is received message as well. Or if it doesn't get any order item information, it's going to print this kind of a message with the status code 400. So that's what the this function app is going to perform. So let's see few other stuff. Okay, so we have to provide this output queue binding in our function.json file. So in the binding section we have to tell, okay, I want to use this output binding because it's going to output the output this message into the queue. So that comes under output binding. So we have to insert that output binding into the function app. So let's try to do that. So the name is output queue. We have to pass the same exact name in here, and it's a queue type, it's out parameter, it's output, it's out binding. So we have to pass the connection string to the queue and the queue name. So we have passed the connection string as my storage connection string. So if you go to the local settings file, you have to insert the connection string as well. So I will insert the connection string information like this. So then in the next video, let's move into Azure portal and create Azure storage account and paste that information into the connection string, storage connection string, and try to deploy this Azure function into the Azure portal.